In the last video, we covered quite a few acronyms describing many of the different protocols out there for implementing web APIs. In this video, let's do some side-by-side comparisons in order to determine which technology is best for what we want to accomplish. SOAP and REST have both been proven as two viable options for implementing a web service. SOAP was originally developed by Microsoft in 1998. For SOAP, we are obliged to use XML for our data structures, but can choose HTTP or another underlying application level protocol. REST was more of a description than a development project. The acronym first appeared in a dissertation by Roy Thomas Fielding in the year 2000. REST uses the HTTP verbs in order to access and manipulate resources, but can use any type of messaging protocol to structure the data it sends. In order for an application to be truly RESTful, it must adhere to a set of constraints Fielding defined in his dissertation. So it seems we still have two good options, but let's take a look at the popularity of the two implementation options over the years. From this data gathered by Programmable Web, we see that REST has gained an astounding popularity over the past decade. A major reason for this is because REST is generally easier to implement than SOAP, and for web developers, working with HTTP is already a familiar practice. For these reasons, this course will focus on designing RESTful web APIs.